in Uganda, 32 Rwandans who were arrested in the west of the country in an operation against people accused of illegally entering the country have been deported. This comes after 24 Ugandans working in Rwanda were also expelled over the weekend, according to local leaders in Kisoro District. The expulsion comes amid tensions between the two East African countries that have festered since Rwanda closed the main common border post in February. The Rwandans arrested on Monday were deported on Tuesday through Kianika border post shortly after they appeared before a magistrate's court and pleaded guilty to legal entry into the country. Joining us now is Magnus Mazimpaka, a Rwandan journalist, to discuss more on this. Magnus, thanks for joining us on the program. What does this latest development say about the relations between both countries at this point?
Thank you for inviting me to the show, but I need to make a few clarifications first. One, we don't have any record of a Rwandan who has crossed to Uganda illegally. That's false. There's no documentation of such a thing. All people, all innocent Rwandans who have been arrested in Uganda actually were not even arrested because they were kidnapped, most of them, rounded up, and they're usually kept in detention centers. They never face charges. They are in hundreds. This is something that has happened for over 2 years. So the incident the other day is just one of them, but on an extreme end. So it's false to say that actually Rwandans crossed to Uganda illegally. First of all, in the East African community, we have a pact. This is an agreement between all the five countries. All citizens in these countries are allowed to travel freely. So this is just a mistreatment of Rwandans in Uganda because of the conflict between the two countries.
Yeah, but talk us through this tension with the border closure. What's the situation with that? Just explain to us what the situation is with this border closure that's causing a lot of tensions between both countries.
Okay, so the thing is, the border closure sounded too much and it made a lot of noise, but it was just almost at the end of, at a time when Rwanda couldn't take it anymore, because hundreds of Rwandans had been tortured, kidnapped on the street, and kept in dungeons with incommunicado and beaten up. They never even gotten chances of being charged or assembled in the courts of law. So it reached a point where you'd see 10, 5, 6, 1 Rwandans deported, almost falling dead at the border, until Rwanda said, no, I think this is too dangerous. Our citizens need to be safe. For Uganda to behave at some point, we need to close the border so that no one crosses on the other side, and until Uganda explains why they are doing this.
Yeah, well, Magnus, isn't
this is at the time when...
Yeah, go ahead.
Yes, this is at a time when you... Let me give you a context in a Nigerian context. Imagine if there is a nearby country, a neighboring country that is keeping, supporting, housing Boko Haram, openly supporting them, speaking to them, giving them all kinds of support, using even military and intelligence and police infrastructure so that they can destabilize Nigeria. How would Nigeria behave?
Yeah, but with
this is the case. It affects
trade, of course. How are residents in this region coping with this?
Because these are communities that have lived together for hundreds of years. It's not a new thing that to find a Ugandan in Rwanda or a Rwandan in Uganda. No, it's not. Actually, some of them, there is even intermarriages. Some Ugandans live in Rwanda halfway and halfway in Uganda. Same way with Rwandans. They even own properties and families, intermarriages.
Yeah.
But it has reached a point where in Rwanda, no one actually understands what happened to Uganda to behave like this. It appears to be that the leadership in Uganda is looking for something that they haven't actually explained, because
yeah.
a lot of official letters have been sent to Uganda asking yeah. diplomatically to explain what Rwanda could have done so that Rwanda can explain. But there's no any explanation given so far.
All right, then, Magnus Mazimpack, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us on the program. Thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome.